You just now saw what print does. It isn't just this. Let us see more of it now. Now, I have 3 TAs in my course. My first TA, let me call it T1, is Amit. T1 equals Amit. When I say print T1, it will show Amit, as you can see. Okay. My second TA's name is Simran. And my third TA's name is Vidya. Now I have T1, T2, T3. Now see what I'm going to do. I'm going to say print hello T1. Inside quotes I'm going to put T1. And then I'm going to close. And guess what will happen? It will say hello T1. Why? Whatever you put within the quotes, it will simply show whatever is inside. That's it. But if I say print hello and then close the quotes and then put a comma and then say T1, close the bracket and then say enter, you see what happened? You probably can guess what is happening here. I need not explain. It is saying hello followed by whatever was stored in T1. What was stored in T1? Amit was stored in T1. So it is simply saying hello Amit. If I were to say print hello T2, it will say hello Simran. If I were to say print hello, don't worry about what comes here. It is a help lookup on how print command works. So please ignore this. This is too much for you to understand or even see what is written here. So just ignore this thing that is coming in here. If I say hello comma T3, it will say hello Vidya. Okay, they are my TAs. I am the instructor. If I say I equals Sudarshan, and now if I say print I, it will simply print Sudarshan. If I say print hello I, it will say hello Sudarshan. Okay, if I say print, see, I can use up arrow to go to the previous command. I just said up arrow. There are 4 arrows, you see, up, down, left, right. If I press up, it goes to the previous command. If I again press up arrow, it goes to this previous command, which is print of I. See, and then the previous. I'll be using this quite often. Don't get confused. Don't be worried how I am able to type something very quickly. I'm just using, this is called the history lookup. I'm just going and seeing the history. So what if I say print hello T1 comma T2 comma T3? What will it display? Let us see what it displays. So it says hello Amit, Simran, Vidya, because T1, T2, T3 are Amit, Simran and Vidya. Now let's do something. Print hello T1, T2, T3, T3 and then comma. How are you all doing today? Then I close. Again, this is self-explanatory, isn't it? You now know what this does. It simply says, hello Amit, Simran, Vidya. How are you all doing today? See, programming is all about this. If I now realize that T1 is Amit, but Amit said, sir, please display my full name. My full name is Amit Verma. Then I'll say, T1 is equal to Amit underscore Verma, let's say. I put it like this. Okay. Now when I say print T1, it says Amit Verma. Now you can wonder, what happened to the previous T1, which was actually Amit? It is overridden. By that I mean, whatever you assign the latest, T1 is Amit Verma, will be the latest value. Okay. If now I say T1 is equal to, let's say, India, T1, print T1 will give you India. Right? Amit Verma is now gone. Correct? Okay. So now let me get back Amit Verma, up arrow, T1 equals Amit Verma. And what I'll do is I will display this once again. Hello T1, T2, T3, how are you all doing? It's look at the output here. It was Hello Amit Chandran Vidya, how are you all doing? Now T1 has become Amit Verma. This T1 is now Amit Verma. So it will say Hello Amit Verma, Simran and Vidya. Simran Vidya, how are you all doing today? See, Hello Amit Verma, Simran Vidya, how are you all doing today? Correct? Now let me enhance this slightly. I would want to put an AND here after T1, T2, I want to put AND, right? When you have three names, after two names, you should put AND. And then after Hello Amit Verma Simran Vidya, I want to put a full stop. So I will put a full stop here before How starts, correct? This, look at this command properly. Look at this entire command properly. Let me highlight it for you. Look at this entire command. What am I trying to do here? I am simply saying Hello T1, T2 and T3, full stop, how are you all doing today? Perfect. It says Hello Amit Verma, Simran and Vidya, how are you all doing today? Amazing. Now you understand how print command works and how you can club variables with print command. Let us conclude this discussion with a very small exercise. I will say age is equal to 30. Enter. Okay. Print the number you entered as was, put age and close. It will say the number you entered was 30. Now if you change age to some 40 and then print, it will say entered was 40. Correct? Now I will say age, whatever was it was, what was it? Print age will tell you what age was. Age was 40. Why not 30? Because you wrote it once again. Once you write age equals 40, the latest assignment for age will be taken. By assignment, I mean 40 gets stored in this variable called age. Okay? If I say age equals age plus 1, this is a little worrisome. What does one mean by age equals age plus 1? Python is a particular way of functioning. When someone says age equals age plus 1, Python simply takes the age value and adds 1 to it and assigns the new value to this, namely age. So print age will show you 41. Correct? Don't worry so much about what these variables are. You will become very clear with them with time. Okay? Variable is more like a house where you store some entity. Right? You keep a book in a cupboard. Right? A variable is like a cupboard and your book is like the value that you assign to. See it that way. It will become very handy for you to call age and the value of age, whatever it is right now, 41, will be ready for your reference. Right? So don't worry, even if you didn't understand, if you understood only 50% of what I taught, still you are through with understanding good amount of Python in the forthcoming lectures.